Welcome back to NJ.com. Jackie Friedman here with the Star Ledger's girls soccer expert, Gregg Lerner. We are deep in county tournament time, so we'll try to break it down for you as best we can. Not many surprises here on the girls' side.
Not in the three tournaments that we're going to talk about tonight, that's for sure.
And we'll get to right talking about these top teams who we think actually belong right where they are. In Bergen, we got Northern Highlands, Ramapo, IHA, and Glenrock still going at it.
Yeah, you know, got to give kudos to all the committees in Bergen, in Essex, in Morris, because they've gotten it right. You got the four top seeds and all those. Two good matchups. The first one, top seed Northern Highlands, who's undefeated, against four seed Glenrock, who's undefeated. A lot of common threads between these two teams. One defense. Northern Highlands, 10 shutouts. Glenrock with 12 shutouts. They've only given up a goal all year. And then they both have two really good feature scorers up top, both of them juniors. Glenrock has Sophie Lederer, and Northern Highlands looks at Madison Hollering. Between those two, we're talking 31 goals. So it'll be interesting to see the resistance against the force in the final third in that one.
Someone's going to win.
Yeah, someone's going to win. And then the second game, Ramapo and IHA. I'm intrigued by IHA because I think we spoke about at the beginning of the year that this was a team that graduated 15 kids.
Thought they'd
from,
be down.
Yeah, 15 kids from a team that had won four straight Bergen County tournaments. And I think it was a matter of patience with IHA. You had to give them a little time for everybody to get acquainted with each other on the field. And now you're starting to see them reap the rewards late in the season. So they got their hands full with Ramapo, but it should be an interesting matchup.
Absolutely. Then over in Morris, Villa Walsh, Randolph, Mendham, Kinnelon, all still alive.
Yeah, and Villa Walsh, talking about living on the edge. Back-to-back weeks of advancing through sudden death penalty kicks. This week it was Allison Ingraham who hits the deciding goal in sudden death. So they're playing tough defensively. But that's the thing in Morris County. Goals are hard to come by. That county has always been like a defensive-oriented county. And nobody can speak on that better than Randolph, which is always a tough, gritty back line that makes life difficult for forwards to go through. That said, Megan Olazowski, who's in the back of junior in the middle, kind of holds things together for Randolph. And she's really going to have to maintain that defensive third shape come Sunday because they're coming up against Mendham. And Mendham features Jamie Hofstetter in the middle of the field, who just has a very good alertness, awareness about what's going on around her. She's complemented by Paige Russell, who's a tough-nosed outside midfielder, and then Devin Russell, her twin sister up top, who's more of a finesse player. So that's going to be a really good contest, I think, one I'm looking forward to. And another one I wanted to mention for Mendham is Faith Sugarman, their goalkeeper. When I saw them a couple weeks ago, really struck me as someone who's a keeper to watch, not just in Morris County, but throughout the state.
And then we will jump to Essex. Montclair, Livingston, Glenridge, West Orange. We've talked about Montclair and Livingston potentially meeting all year, and it could happen. Maybe not.
Could happen. They're going to have to get through Wednesday, that semifinals Wednesday night at Livingston. Montclair gets West Orange, and I happen to see West Orange on Saturday. And I can't say enough about Raven Edwards, their senior forward. I think she's got 21 goals now. What I really like about Raven is, as a forward, she operates on touch. She plays with her back to the goal. She likes to bring a defender on top of her so she can manipulate that defender with a quick move. But beyond that, her touch on the ball and the fact that, although labeled as a scorer, she is always looking to get people involved. She understands that she's going to draw added attention,
right,
and that it's going to mean someone's open. So she looks to play balls off. What's interesting for West Orange is that Allison Mejia is injured right now. She hurt her ankle. I spoke to her briefly on Saturday. She hopes to be back within a week. I don't know if that week is going to include on Wednesday.
Right.
So that's going to be a big absence. But they showed on Sunday against Caldwell, or Saturday against Caldwell, that they can adapt, in her absence.
Absolutely.
You mentioned Livingston. The interesting thing, they're playing Glenridge. Livingston getting beaten by Montclair.
Pretty badly.
Yeah, I mean, 4-0, that's a pretty resounding result. But I also think it probably lit a spark under Livingston a little bit. I'm sure they want to get another crack at Montclair.
Take three.
Yeah, take three. And they have the weaponry to do that. We've talked about the Flores twins and what they can do, and Clara Shear up top. But Glenridge is another team that has good defense. And Claire Malone, I'm assuming Claire, who can get forward. When I saw her earlier this year against Nutley, she played in the back as a central defender. And I got a feeling that might be her role come Wednesday night, because Glenridge is going to need all hands on deck in the back.
Well, we will keep you posted as best we can, so keep coming back to NJ.com and the Star Ledger. He's Gregg Lerner. I'm Jackie Friedman. We'll see you next time.